Don't you hate it when someone points out a ghastly fact about your favorite snack or body product? Well, now you can arm yourself with a few delightful facts of your own. With this information, you can ensure at least one of your friends either loses their appetite or their interest in purchasing an item ever again. From the pork fat riddled body soap to the sweet made from animal remains, here are 15 things you'll never buy once you know what they're made of. Before we begin, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell for more amazing videos every day. That being said, let's begin. Number 15. Soap made from animal fat. With pork fat as its main ingredient, you would be forgiven for thinking this artisan soap should stay on the shelves. And with a name like Filthy Pig Soaps, you could see why they might. Founded by Joe Tangney, the soap smells like pineapple and relies on lard that, when mixed with sodium hydroxide, becomes soap. Many New Yorkers have reservations. However, lard has long been used as a base for soaps and creates a dense, long-lasting, and moisturizing bar. Tangney, who lives in Bushwick and works as a bartender, says it's a great soap, made from the fat of free-range pigs, so it's particularly soft on your skin. For those uncomfortable with the thought, he offers this reminder: we eat meat, we eat fat, we drink fat in milk, and we wear animal skin on our bodies as clothes. Therefore, taking our relationship with pig fat to the next level is really no big deal, according to Tangney. The idea to use pig fat to make soap came about when he was working at the West Village's Fatty Crab. He had noticed the chef scraping the lard off a braised pork belly and simply throwing it out. Believing this waste could be avoided, Tangney's research led him to a soap maker in Virginia. Rochelle Sparger buys lard from Columbus Foods and combines this with a mix of scented oils that Tangney hand selects. The finished bars are sent to him to wrap and label and are then sold under his brand Filthy Pig Soaps online, at local meat shops, grocery stores, and healthcare boutiques. A fairly ghastly process that's considered outdated on today's market, where plant-derived options are preferred. I guess only time will tell whether Tangney's pig fat soaps will prove popular or not. Number 14. Marshmallow. There's nothing quite like the taste of a heated marshmallow toasted over an open campfire or bonfire. In fact, it's a tradition that's been enjoyed by many over the years, roasting said marshmallows on a wooden stick. But what of these little foam eatable pillows? What are they made from? A question that has probably never been asked, particularly by the youngsters enjoying their gooey goodness, and unfortunately, the news isn't good. Not many people know this because confectionery industries aren't keen to divulge their secrets, but over the years, the ingredients in marshmallows have changed. Where they were once made from a flour called marshmallow, they are now made from a combination of things, including gelatin, which is used to give them their cushiony, cloud-like texture. Unfortunately, gelatin is made from the boiled skin and bone remains of cows and pigs, the scraps left over from the meat industry. Suddenly, the practice of roasting marshmallows over a campfire doesn't sound quite so appealing, does it? Number 13. Hot dog. An all-time American favorite for hundreds of years, the hot dog has tempted the taste buds of the young and old throughout the ages. Whether purchased from a street vendor or at the county fair, the classic hot dog is just as popular today as it ever was. Unfortunately, this old favorite is made from scraps. In fact, after the steaks, chops, breasts, ribs, thighs, hams, tenderloins, and briskets are removed from a butchered animal, there's a fair amount of gristle, fat, and offal remaining. These remains are used to make pre-cooked and processed gems like the traditional American hot dog. According to the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations, FAO, hot dog sausage may consist of meat trimmings, fat, flavoring, and preservatives. A vague term, trimmings, could include fatty tissues, feet, skin, liver, and any other byproducts that are considered edible. Yum. Number 12. Natural brushes. Given the world's current preoccupation with all things wholesome and unprocessed, you'd be forgiven for thinking it was a good idea to choose all natural when it comes to your makeup brushes. But experts advise that it pays to tread carefully when choosing from the forest of possibilities available on today's market, as it seems there's no telling where the natural animal hair has come from, not to mention how it was obtained. If you are in any way concerned about animal welfare, which, let's face it, most of us are, you will agree that it's important to consider a brush's origins. The vegans amongst you will be out of the natural camp already, but for the curious folk, you'll be interested to know that natural makeup brushes are often made from squirrel, goat, Kalinsky weasel, mink, and occasionally horse or even badger hair. Synthetic brushes, on the other hand, are predominantly made from melted and spun plastics like nylon. Naturally sourced brushes are more expensive than synthetic, as the materials used are more difficult to track down, especially if the manufacturer is looking for soft, uniform size and color. Restrictions on fur harvesting can also force prices to rapidly rise, so the synthetic option is looking better and better. Number 11. Red candy. When it comes to red candy, I think Valentine's Day or Christmas, never considering what said candy might be made from. When you bite into a candy cane, do you ever wonder how the red color is created, or do you just think red food dye? If so, you'd be partially correct, but how is the dye made? Next time you're enjoying your festive peppermint delight, consider this. Although bright cherry red candy gets people's attention and is a fabulous addition to the Christmas table, some red food dye is made from bugs. Yeah, you heard that right. Check the ingredients listed on the back of your candy canes. If you see carmine, cochineal extract, or natural red 4, you can be sure several bugs were crushed when creating your sweet treat of choice. Cochineal extract is extracted from the cochineal, a bug mainly harvested in Peru and the Canary Islands on plantations of prickly pear cacti. The bugs, specifically the female of the species, are sun-dried, crushed, and dunked in an acidic alcohol solution. The carminic acid produced eventually becomes carmine or cochineal extract, depending on processing. If you think that's bad, it takes a whopping 70,000 of these insects to produce a pound of dye. It's little wonder Starbucks have stopped using this type of red food dye. However, they are not the only coffee purveyor guilty of using this additive. Number 10. Mushrooms. Thinking of adding a little flavor to your evening meal? Well, if you're considering a can of mushrooms, you might get more than you bargained for. Apparently, canned mushrooms have proven a great hiding place for maggots over the years. And worse still, the Food and Drug Administration aren't really bothered by this revelation. In fact, unless there are over 20 or more maggots of any size, or 5 or more maggots of 2 millimeters or longer per 100 grams of drained mushrooms, don't bother the FDA, because they're not interested. Gross. A common addition to the cans, Americans are said to ingest 1 to 2 pounds of flies, maggots, and mites without knowing it. And the FDA guidelines, established in 1995 and revised multiple times since, say this is safe. So if the thought of getting a little extra protein with your mushrooms turns your stomach, it might be best to avoid the canned variety from now on. Number 9. Shredded cheese. Handy for a pizza topping, cheese sauce, or lasagna, grated cheese is commercially produced and often blended with other varieties of cheese. Hard or aged cheeses are typically used for this purpose, but although very handy, it's not advised to buy the pre-packaged grated variety, and here's why. The difference between a block of cheese and pre-grated cheese is the ingredient cellulose. Cellulose is a common ingredient in grated cheese, ensuring the cheese doesn't become moist or clumpy. It's not that cellulose itself is bad. In fact, it helps us digest food. The issue is that the added cellulose required for grated cheese heightens the gluten content, not ideal for those following a gluten-free diet when the cheese is labeled gluten-free. Plain cheese made with as few ingredients as possible will have undetectable levels of gluten in virtually every case. However, anti-clumping agents used by cheese manufacturers, such as cellulose, which can be made from a gluten grain, should be identified on the product's label. Number 8. Vanilla extract. Considered an essential ingredient in many Western desserts, vanilla extract is a solution made by grinding, blending, and filtering vanilla pods in a solution of ethanol and water. Although its primary flavor is vanillin, pure vanilla extract contains several hundred additional flavor compounds. Artificial vanilla flavor, on the other hand, is manufactured solely from artificially derived vanillin, often made from a byproduct of tree bark. In order to get from tree
tree bark to vanilla flavoring, manufacturers add a variety of ingredients, including solvents, preservatives, and other chemicals. Worse still, they are not required to disclose any of this on the label. And when you consider that these additives can make up to 90% of the flavoring, it's obvious the vanilla extract is anything but natural. Technically, natural flavors must start as something that resembles food, whereas artificial flavors do not. Often derived from man-made chemicals, these artificial flavors may induce food cravings, lead to headaches, and small allergic reactions in some people. Number 7. Perfumes. If you think that perfume you've just caught a whiff of smells a little off, you could be right, particularly if it's of the expensive variety. Exotic, complex, and fabulously expensive perfumes may include secretions, digestions, and excretions of animals. In fact, animal essences have been prized right throughout history, used in perfumes, incense, and flavorings. They range from sperm whale vomit and cat feces to the hardened poop of the tiny hyrax or fossilized badger urine. Nauseating to most people, they are fiercely sought after, and once diluted, reveal an incredible beauty and delicacy. The use of some of these ingredients is not without controversy, however, as they cannot be obtained without killing or harming the animal. Progress is being made in this area, with sustainable and humane methods being researched. Number 6. Chewing gum. A flavored and sweetened rubber, it is little wonder children are encouraged never to swallow their chewing gum. For one, the body takes years to digest it, and it comes as no surprise considering some of its ingredients. Chewing gum contains both lanolin and synthetic plastic. Why the waxy secretion from sheep's wool, which helps make it waterproof, is used in the manufacturing of a chewable candy, I'm not sure. But it is only one part of a list of questionable additives, including aspartame, inflammatory titanium dioxide, and possibly carcinogenic butylated hydroxyanisole, or BHA. Unsurprisingly, the ingredients in the base of chewing gum are not disclosed by the companies. Instead, they are listed simply as gum base to disguise the inclusion of petroleum, lanolin, glycerin, polyethylene, polyvinyl acetate, petroleum wax, stearic acid, and latex. Now, when you think of the dirty chewing gum stuck on sidewalks, park benches, and bus seats, you'll understand why it stays put for years. Made from plastic, it is yet another form of plastic pollution and a blight on both our landscape and our gut. Number 5. Salad dressing. Adding a touch of flavor to your salad of choice seems a harmless enough task, until you consider the ingredients that make up the dressing. Titanium dioxide is something we associate with paint and industrial use. However, it's also used in foods such as ranch dressing and other creamy salad dressings. The inorganic pigment serves as a whitener in many foods, including candies, baked goods, and other dairy products, icings, and toppings. But is this chemical dangerous? Exposure to nanoparticles of titanium dioxide, or E171, and other additives was once considered harmful to the immune system. However, this has never been proven. A 2017 study by the French National Institute for Agricultural Research, however, has shown that titanium dioxide nanoparticles are absorbed by the intestine and passed into the bloodstream of animals after oral exposure. Rats exposed to regular oral doses of the chemical for 100 days determined that chronic oral exposure led to a non-malignant stage of carcinogenesis, the process of normal cells becoming cancer cells, in 40% of exposed animals. Not exactly reassuring, is it? Number 4. Ultra-processed food. It's hardly breaking news that eating too many fatty foods can knock years off your life, not to mention increase your waistline. However, new research has found that deaths from heart disease, cancer, and other illnesses are linked to the consumption of ultra-processed food. These foods include chips, white bread, ready meals, sausages, and sugary treats. And worryingly, they make up half of the average Briton's diet. We all know that the food we eat plays a significant role in our health, with highly processed foods not providing the nutrients our body requires. The good news is that not every food that comes in a box is ultra-processed. An international panel of food scientists and researchers has created a classification list to help those confused by this statement. The system, called NOVA, splits foods into into four categories: unprocessed foods, minimally processed foods, processed foods, and ultra-processed foods. Unprocessed or minimally processed foods are best described as real, whole foods, including vegetables, fruits, meats, eggs, and milk. Processed foods contain additives. However, most have been altered, but not in a way that is considered detrimental to your health. Finally, ultra-processed foods are where almost half of our calories come from. Hence, these foods should be kept to a minimum and include the old favorites like chocolate, chips, and candy. Not surprising and a little upsetting, but as they say, you are what you eat, and I am garbage. Number 3. Energy drinks. In 2019, students from City Hill Middle School in Naugatuck, Connecticut, traveled with their science teacher, Katrina Spina, to the state capitol to testify in support of a bill that would ban sales of energy drinks to children under the age of 16. As part of a chemistry unit, the students had studied the ingredients and potential health impacts of several energy drinks over a three-month period. They concluded that heightened consumption could be fatal, particularly for adolescents. Their research also found that energy drinks are incredibly popular amongst kids, offer zero nutritional value, and include excessive amounts of caffeine that can lead to high blood pressure, nausea, vomiting, and convulsions. Other adverse health effects linked to excessive energy drink consumption, as illustrated in a study published in the International Journal of Health Sciences in 2015, include anxiety, insomnia, gastronomical upset, headaches, hyperactivity, and diarrhea. A study in Sweden also found links between energy drinks and dental erosion. Pediatric dietitian and British Dietetic Association spokesperson Claire Thornton-Wood said high levels of sugar and caffeine impact on obesity, tooth decay, blood pressure, and concentration at school. Young people who drink an excessive number of energy drinks per day to avoid eating are also said to have an increased risk of heart arrhythmia from the high doses of caffeine. Number 2. Mac and cheese. If the color of boxed mac and cheese doesn't put you off, maybe its list of dangerous ingredients will. Considered the ultimate comfort food, it may be hearty and satisfying, but it is also chock full of dangerous chemicals, including high levels of phthalates. These toxins have been attributed to testosterone reduction and birth abnormalities. The reason boxed mac and cheese is high in phthalates is because of the plastic involved in processing, plus its fat content. These toxins are a cause of real concern, as the threshold doses aren't known. They are especially dangerous for infants and expecting females, and the risks of the toxin are not widely advertised either. In fact, phthalates are everywhere, not just in mac and cheese. They can leach into your packaged foods and out of flooring and furniture. If we travel back in time to the late 1800s, when we lived in a world that wasn't littered with plastic, life was a lot simpler and a lot less toxic. However, plastic was too hard to mold into useful objects, and some genius discovered that camphor was good at making plastic softer, flexible, and easier to work with, and suddenly everything changed. Camphor was replaced by phthalates in the 1930s due to its pungent odor, and by the 1950s, plastic was everywhere. It wasn't until the 1970s that researchers started speculating about the health effects of phthalates in foods, and only now is it finally getting some public spotlight. Yet another reason to remind ourselves that just because it's easy doesn't mean that we should eat it. Number 1. Nutella. Nuts, cocoa, and 58% sugar are the basic ingredients of Nutella. The lovely brown gloop that's become so popular since its inception just over 50 years ago is more than a little unhealthy. So, it contains nuts, and that's about where the healthy portion ends. In fact, this delicious spread is basically half sugar and a third fat. Not only that, but Nutella includes the second most evil of all the oils: palm oil. These plantations have caused severe deforestation, threatened wildlife, and the global climate. Ferrero, the manufacturers of Nutella, trace their palm oil back to sustainable plantations, which is at least one plus. However, it could and should do more. These irresponsible food companies make sweet things that we like, have us believe they are healthy, and then we're hooked. Once we find out that our favorite snack is incredibly unhealthy, it's so much harder to give up. And what about the palm oil? According to the European Food Safety Authority, it has been proven that high temperature refining may lead to an increase in potentially carcinogenic contaminants that have been linked to cancer. However, the authority doesn't necessarily think it's unsafe. Now, that's comforting, isn't it? No matter the concerns raised, Ferrero wasn't planning any recipe changes, as they believe an inferior substitute would be a step backward. The company also uses about 185,000 tons of palm oil a year, so switching it out wouldn't be easy. And Nutella isn't the only delicious treat made with the oil. Chocolate bars, ice cream, cookies, and pizza dough also contain palm oil. It would require real commitment to live without all these. Now, wouldn't it? Are you the type that checks the ingredients of everything you eat? I, for one, don't ever seem to have the time, but it probably pays to at least glance over them from time to time. Imagine finding out you've been consuming a dangerous toxin on a regular basis. Not exactly ideal, is it? Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time.